Good rainy Thursday morning, everybody. Oh, let me stop and grab this bucket. Let's check on everybody real quick and then I'll give you an update. I just got to look in here and see how much food I need. My goodness, what'd you guys do? They're all laying inside the trailer where it's nice and dry. And I'll have to show you in a few minutes. They've got their food trough moved, so I had to locate it so I could see. They've probably emptied it. Yeah, they have for the most part. Now, yesterday, they were still really busy rooting around outside and hadn't eaten a whole lot of food yet. So I didn't have to really give them a whole lot yesterday evening. So I don't want to give them too much, you know, and then them just make a big mess and waste it. But I also want to make sure they have plenty, you know, so they grow like they're supposed to. So anyway, how are y'all doing today? As it is, it's been rainy and it's muddy. I don't know if you can see this. This is what I'm trudging through, so I'm trying to be very careful. And where we moved the trailer and then brought in feed, we've just made more of a mess back here, so we can't seem to get it dry enough long enough when we have finances to get some rock back here. But it's coming. We'll get it done. Okay, we're in the barn. Good morning, guys. Good morning. Good morning. They're fussing. They're saying you're late. I am kind of late this morning. We, well, I was fixing breakfast for one thing, and then well, they've still got plenty of water. We've got lots of rain, so they're good on water. Let's see, I fixed breakfast, and then we've been dealing with the people that we bought a car from Katie. There's a whole big mess there behind it, and we're trying to get it straightened out. We're just having a hard time getting a hold of the people. They don't want to answer the phone. So anyway, it's just one of those things. We'll get through it, but we need to get it done because she goes back to school here. The 22nd is when she starts back to classes. So exciting. She's a sophomore in college and it's like, oh my gosh, it's my baby. And then Michael is a junior in high school this year. So wow, that is, he is my baby. He is my last child. Not including our grandson Jace. So anyway, let me get these guys fed and then we'll talk some more. Okay, I've got everybody fed. See Mr. Elliot back here behind me. He's eating. And here's the girls. Anyway, I was just watching. It's like she's trying to get into his lot, which is going to be a no-no. Mm-mm. We don't want any more piglets for a few months. Brian and I were sitting down last night and trying to figure out when we want to breed again. We actually had a phone call yesterday, or I did, from another gentleman looking for some piglets. And we don't have any right now. So he asked to be put on the waiting list for the spring. So we have, I think, a waiting list of about 5 or 6 people right now, which is really good. And if, you know, if there's 6 and they each take 2, that's 12 if we have 12 piglets and they all survive. I think what we're talking about, I think, is breeding Sophie in November. I'm trying to think what I wrote down. I think it's November, and then Parker in January. So that way, there's a gap between the two litters, but there's not so much of a gap that we can't get them sold before they get too old. And we want, you know, most people want a fall butcher, and so that's what we, what we're trying to plan for. And that's one of the things when you homestead and you raise animals like this, especially if you're planning to sell them, you have to plan as much as you possibly can when you want to breed your animals and when you want them born, and you know, for anything, even cows, chickens, anything like that, you have to plan when you plan to butcher. If that's the end goal, you have to plan from the time that you breed, from the time they're born, to the time that they can be slaughtered. And so that's something we were trying to plan out for this next batch, since we did not plan these ladies getting pregnant this time around. So, but God was gracious, and we ended up selling them, even though we had a hard time getting started in it. So we definitely wanted to make sure that we plan in the future. I mean, we've got taken the steps that we need to keep them apart, to keep them from being able to breed whenever they so choose. So that is our game plan right now. But let's go check on the little ones and see how they're doing. There's a little clip of them in the trailer with their little trough. And yeah, they kind of have to take turns, but it doesn't matter how big of a trough that you feed a pig out of, they're always going to fight over the food. Always. I mean, the term eating like a pig, that one is accurate. Now, as far as, you know, something looking like a pigsty, pigs are actually fairly clean. They get the bad reputation because they have to have the mud to keep cool. So, they're actually fairly clean animals. I mean, they're still an animal. You know, they're still going to poop and pee wherever, but, you know, they're actually fairly clean animals. So, anyway, let's check on
these
little chicks.
Good morning, guys. Good morning. Hey. Good morning. We have poo on us. Y'all been fighting, huh? You been fighting? Trying to take dominance? You see everybody's doing really well. They're all piled up in the corner. Getting ready to turn the heat lamp off. I think they're a little bit warm. Like I said, I'm a little late getting down here. So let's check on
okay.
things here.
Everybody's taken care of. Today is the day that two of the three that are leaving Piglet was will be leaving us this afternoon. And we have a guy coming today to pick up two piglets. He's coming from Georgia. So two will be leaving today. I've got to try to get in touch with the other guy today and see if he wants to come get his one or if he wants to wait for another day. Either way is fine with us. It's not a big deal, you know, because they're going to be up here for a few weeks anyway till they're fully weaned and Parker's milk has completely dried up. Hey everyone, it's evening feeding time here. We have had lots and lots of rain, so I'm having to really, really watch where I step here. We just got through sending two of our little piggies to their new home. Couple's very, very nice. Just starting to raise pigs themselves, but I think they're going to do just fine. Tell her, you know, give me a call. If she had any questions, you know, if I don't know the answer, I'll help her find it. So we are now down to five piglets in this litter. So here, I'll show you what everybody's doing. These are the five that's left. The one with the little jacket, he went to his home, and the one of the little girls. So we now have three boys and two girls left. They're not quite sure what to think of having their siblings gone and all the racket, of course, but we lock them in the trailer so we can catch them easier, and then we let them back out, so, which is part of the reason we move them up here. So let's get these guys fed. I know they're hungry. Come on, guys. Come on, guys. Come eat. Come on. Arian's come. Alrighty, yep, there you go. Yeah, you had your slop treat earlier. You gotta have old feed this time. That one right there is always in the feed trough. whether it's sitting in it, standing in it, or laying in it. It's always bittersweet when we sell them. They are my babies. You know, I take care of them and treat them as mine, as my little ones, so to speak. You know, but it's what we're doing. We're raising them for food and raising them to sell. So now I gotta take care of the chicks and get back up to the house. Okay, it's the end of another day. I didn't get to video the pigs leaving today, which I was hoping to do, but that's okay. Again, we're down to five. We want one more to leave, and then the other four will be here until December when we send them to slaughter. So it's moving, you know, God's blessing. We're selling pigs, and actually, I mean, they're all spoken for, so that's a huge blessing. So I picked Michael up a little bit ago, got home. We ate a late supper. Got some dishes I need to at least get rinsed if I don't, if I don't load the dishwasher tonight. I'll have to admit I'm pretty tired. Did not sleep well last night. Jace was, he crashed early last night, and then he was up from 3 to almost 6 before he really, really, really went back to sleep. He would doze off and on, but he was very fidgety and just did not sleep well. So, I'm pretty tired. So, I think I'm going to call it a night here. Like I said, I'm at least going to rinse some dishes so I don't leave food sitting on anything. And then it's ready for me to load in the morning. So, don't forget to check out all my media links down below for Facebook, Instagram, and Pinterest. And also, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, showing me that you like it, and that lets YouTube know that you like it, and kind of bump it up a little bit. And also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you never miss a new video. So y'all have a good night, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.